Stream, the so-called Stanford Stream Data Manager, was proposed by authors, well, from Stanford in 2003, and is aiming at being a general purpose data stream management system for streams, but also for stored data. And the authors have proposed CQL, a query language that allows us to also incorporate statements on sliding windows. So basically you can imagine CQL as being SQL plus streams plus windows and some new semantics. There are three relation to stream operators, iStream, dStream, and rStream, and there's also the possibility for sampling. We will walk through that in a few minutes. And here is one more time this relation with vehicle ID, speed, and so on. We will also use that later on in some queries. Let's have a look at an example query. There are two streams, orders, that contain order ID, the customer, and the cost, and fulfillments about the orders and which clerk was responsible for this fulfillment. And what we want to compute now is a query that computes the total cost of orders fulfilled over the last day by the clerk Sue for customer Joe. Now, if you say, let's say we have the query compute all the sum of the orders fulfilled by clerk Sue for customer Joe in SQL, forgetting about streams, we all know how to do it, right? We do a join between orders and fulfillments based on the order ID, of course, filter for clerk equals Sue, and the customer should be Joe. So this is nothing different to what we do here. We see we have select sum of the costs from orders and fulfillments, where the order ID matches the other order ID. This is clear, this is the join condition, and the clerk is Sue and the customer is Joe. So the only thing which is new here now is the introduction of windows, because orders and fulfillments are two streams and the database system handles relations. Now we talk about streams, so we have to somehow be able to express how do we handle streams. And as we have seen earlier, we can handle streams easily by putting a window over the streams, which transforms the stream into a relation, and then the system, normal database system, would know how to handle it, just doing the computation on the windows. So what is the window we need? Well, we need, according to the query, the last day only. That means we are computing here the information given a time-based window with a range of one day. So this is pretty much SQL, as I mentioned already, and having this addition that we can specify windows over the data streams, because these are data streams here, right? The orders and fulfillments. Another example, using a 10% sample of the fulfillment stream, we want to take the 5 most recent fulfillments for each clerk and return the maximum cost. Easy. Forget about sampling and 5 most recent. We know how to write this in SQL, right, for relations. So now what we have in addition is the specification of sampling, which is done here, so 10% sample. And here for the fulfillments, we are partitioning the stream based on the clerk, and for each of the clerks, we're taking the last 5 rows. This is like the syntax here. And then we have these partitions, which are 5 rows for every clerk. And based on this, we can do a group by the clerk and return the maximum cost. And of course, this is here the typical normal join condition between orders and fulfillments. So again, you see, nothing really magical happens. It's SQL, but for the streams, you have to do something, because in SQL, you don't have the notion of streams. So you have to turn streams into relations. This we do by specifying a window here. And in addition, we can also apply sampling. This is the syntax in CQL to introduce sampling. So let's clarify the connection between relations and streams. First of all, here in stream and in CQL, we consider a discrete ordered time domain. So let's say 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. And the relation R is a mapping from time T to a bag of tuples belonging to the schema of R. That means we do not have only relations, but relations depending on the time. So you see here the parameter T for the relation R. A stream is a set of elements of the form tuple and timestamp. So we have streams and relations. If we have a stream and want to make a relation out of it, well, we take a window specification. Then we come from the world of streams into the world of relations. Now we can use any relational query language, of course, for instance, SQL, to operate on these relations. So how can we now turn these relations into streams again? For this, we have three special operators, iStream, dStream, and rStream. So let's first talk about the case of having a stream and you want to turn it into a relation. We have seen already in the examples that we do this by specifying a window. And this is then here a relation. At time t, this relation contains all tuples in the window of this stream s up to time point t. When the window is like unbounded, then it contains all tuples from the stream up to point in time t. And again, as I mentioned some slides earlier, there are multiple ways to construct sliding windows, and also this is supported in CQL. You can have a time-based window, tuple-based window, or as we have already seen in the example, also we have a partitioned window for the clerk example. We can specify, for instance, time-based windows. Here we see how we can do this using a range over 30 seconds, or we say the range is now. In this case, we get only the tuples from this very time point, or we can also say the range is unbounded. And as I said earlier, if we have a time-based window, the number of records in the window varies, if the data rate varies. We can have tuple-based windows. Here we can, for instance, say we want to have only one row, or we can have rows unbounded. Here, then we have parameter n for the rows if it's not unbounded, and then tuples come in and leave the window when new tuples come into the system. We can have partitioned windows like in the example earlier. We have a data stream S, and then we partition the stream by attributes, and then for each of these groups we can take n tuples. This is like similar to group by in SQL. So you're taking these partitions, computing based on these rows the sliding window, and then you take the union over the tuples that qualify. Okay, this is like quite easy to understand, right? You have a stream, you want to turn it into a relation, you have to work with windows. So now, in illustration earlier, we have seen we have this world of streams to relations. And if we are at the relation world, we can, of course, write arbitrary SQL queries and transform relations into other relations, right? For instance, here we have a simple SQL query on this relation here. And this relation, as you can see, is the stream and the window definition, right? Any query that we can write in SQL, we can also write here. So the interesting part, and maybe perhaps the most confusing part, is the part on how can we transform a relation back to a stream. For this, we have three operators, iStream, dStream, and rStream. And this works as follows. So we have a query that is select from, and you know, right? You have a stream and a window definition and some complicated SQL query. Now the result here depends of course on the time, because the stream is evolving over time, and this query gives us for different time points different results. So this here, the result depends on the time. So you can imagine this as a parameter indicating the time point. And this is exactly leading to the definitions here. If you're applying the iStream on this result, on this relation, then at time point t, it contains all tuples which are in this result, in this relation, at time point t, but were not in this result at time point t minus 1. Hence, this is also called the insert stream. Likewise, the d stream stands for delete stream. Here, d stream applied on a relation r, in this sense here, contains a stream element, a tuple t, if this tuple, or this tuple r, if this tuple r was in the relation at the time t minus 1 minus the relation at this point in time. That means we look at stream elements that have been deleted. And the r stream, this is simply containing the stream elements which are in this result at the time point t. So you would output then at every point in time, the stream would look at the definitions here. For instance, the iStream would output for time point t, and then for time point t plus 1, t plus 2, and so on, always according to this definition. And the same for the other streams as well. Note here that we have multiset semantics. So this is what I said, the iStream contains all tuples in R that are new within the last time period. The dStream contains the tuples which were there before, but not anymore, so the delete stream. And RStream contains all tuples in R. And it's interesting that iStream and dStream can be expressed with RStream and suitable selection predicates and window specification, and this is a good exercise to think how you can do that. Some examples here, we have our sample highway data stream. Range unbounded means we look at all of the contents at a certain time point. We want to have only those entries where the speed of the vehicle is larger than 65, and from that result we want to turn this into an iStream containing all of the attributes. Here, for the rStream, we look at the window specification that is only taking the current tuples at the time point where the speed is larger than 65, like above. And here we look at the rStream. And this means that if you look at the definition of the query, so this part here, this is our relation, and the iStream is then always delivering at time point t those tuples from the entire stream, because it's unbounded, that were not in this stream before. And since the range is here unbounded, it doesn't really matter at which point in time we are regarding the old tuples. We are always emitting only the new tuples that qualify speed larger than 65. And here we have the R stream. That means we don't care if the item was there or not. We always output all the tuples according to this relation definition. And this is defined by a window now. That means we only look at the tuples at this very time point that have speed larger than 65. And if you can follow, these two queries should be identical in the results they're producing. By the way, we are combining here the different predicates, or different predicates, not in this case, but different query window descriptions. So for the better understanding, again, what are the query results at a time point T? If we have relations, then these are the relations that, or tuples in the relations at time point T. If we have streams, we look at the stream content up to time point T. Of course, we cannot look into the future. And we take a window specification to convert these streams into relations. And then we compute simply using SQL the results. And if wanted, if needed, we can convert the results into streams using iStream, dStream, or rStream, depending on our application. So here's a bit more complicated example. We have here the clerk selected and the maximum of the order costs from an orders table and fulfillments table. Of course, we have to join the tables and we want to group here based on the clerk. No problem, we can do this. What we see here is that here we have an unbounded window for the orders, and here for the fulfillments, we have a window looking only at the last 1,000 rows of the fulfillment table. So at time point T, we look at the entire stream of orders. That means the relation contains the entire stream and the last tuples for the fulfillment. And then we compute the join. That means here we are interested in the latest 1,000 fulfillments. However, since we want to also find information about the orders, here the orders is not bound by any time window or count window, but here we have available for the computation of the join the entire orders table. This is then evaluated using the SQL query, and this, if you're executing this, corresponds to the relation, that is the query result, at time point T. If you're making now an iStream of this, then it will produce a streaming result, and the result will consist of the clerk, the maximum of the cost of the orders, and the time point T whenever clerk, comma, max changes from the previous time point. Right, so whenever the result of the query here changes, then you output a stream tuple for this query now. And this query, the big one now, is now a stream, right? In the previous slide, it was a relation. Now it is a stream because here we use the relation to stream operator. So what is the following query doing? We have here an iStream over a query which computes the average A from a relation S with a range of 5 seconds. And well, first of all, we take a stream, take a 5 minute sliding window, 5 second sliding window, and compute the average. And we output the average only if the average is changing. This is the iStream, that's important, right? If you want to emit the result every time step, you have to use the rStream. If you want to emit the results for every second, then you can do the same query, but you have to specify how this window is specified. So not only that it's 5 seconds large, but that it is sliding every second. So you see, you can, this is like not maybe so trivial to see, but this is basically only SQL with a bit of flavor coming from the data stream part.